speakers, because you know that our institution is trying to develop more collaboration. It's not only for from university in Indonesia, but also like UPM and other university overseas, and also develop more collaboration for private sector. For example, like CV Island Food, Mas Ahmad Nasution, we're really glad having you today. And I just want to inform a little information related to the shifting of the paradigm of the higher education right now. The Ministry of Education mandate us to open collaboration with the private sector in order to increase the matching, the what's connection between what we have done in the university and what are needs for you know the job market, for the job market. So for Mas Ahmad Nasution, we really wanna invite you as a part of our partner in Merdeka Belajar program initiated by Mas Menteri Pak Nadiem. So if you don't mind, probably we can connect again another time for developing more collaboration in implementing Merdeka Belajar program. So from with Faculty of Agriculture and CV Ailani Food. Hopefully that will be possible for the next. And then Bu Juwaida, we really you know, hope that UPM and Faculty of Agriculture, especially and University of Brawijaya more generally, to you know have opportunity to strengthen more about our collaboration, so we can work together. It's not only for research and also education, and probably we can also initiate some project related to community development, for example. I think that will be great for us. So the existence of university is not only for ourselves, but also for community development. So I think we really great welcome for Dr. Juwaida and also Mas Ahmad Nasution. And we are really thanks for sharing the experiences for us and also knowledge about customer value proposition, because this is, I think, it's very important to differentiate between the traditional business and the more modern business, which is the connection between the producer and the seller and the consumer is getting close and close. So I think this is my speech. Thank you very much again for your coming, for your sharing with us. And hopefully that will be strengthened for the next collaboration with Faculty of Agriculture. Again, thank you very much, and come back to the moderator, Mas Irfan. I'm sorry if I'm mistaken in my speech. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you to Mr. Sujarwo for the welcome speech. And saya ingatkan sekali lagi untuk peserta yang nanti mempunyai pertanyaan terkait dengan jalannya webinar pada siang hari ini, silakan untuk dapat mempersiapkan pertanyaannya mulai dari sekarang, sehingga nanti ketika sesi tanya jawab bisa langsung ditanyakan dan tidak perlu menunggu lama, bisa langsung dijawab oleh pemateri-pemateri, baik itu nanti dari Ibu Juwaidah maupun dari Bapak Ahmad Syakban Nasution. Dan juga untuk absensinya nanti kami berikan di akhir acara. Baik, langsung kita mulai saja. Let's start the webinar. Our webinar session today will be led by Ms. Novi Haryati. Novi Haryati SPMP. She is a senior lecturer from Brawijaya University. Her current research expertise is in agribusiness marketing management. Hello, Ms. Novi. How are you?
Hello, I'm fine. Thank you.
Ms. Novi, are you ready for this webinar?
Yes, yes. Okay, thank you.
Okay. Baik. To Ms. Novi Haryati, time is yours.
Okay, good morning. Good afternoon, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The Honorable the Vice Dean, our professor in Agricultural Economics Department, lecturers and doctors, and our speakers. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Novi Haryati. I'm from Agricultural Department, Faculty of Agriculture, Brawijaya University. I'll be responsible for hosting these presentations, and this international webinar will use both Bahasa and English. So, mudah-mudahan semuanya bisa berpartisipasi di siang hari yang cukup berbahagia ini. So, ladies and gentlemen, this international webinar is held with the background of understanding customer value proposition. According to Principle of Marketing by Kotler and Armstrong 2012, the value proposition is the full mix of benefit on which a brand is differentiated and positioned. The purpose of value proposition is to convince customer to choose one brand over another based on unique point of difference. In bahasa Indonesia, kurang lebihnya penciptaan value atau nilai sebuah produk itu dihasilkan dengan menawarkan sejumlah keunggulan produk, baik itu dalam bentuk berwujud maupun tidak berwujud. Hal ini meliputi desain, warna, ukuran, kemasan, dan sebagainya. Sedangkan atribut yang tidak berwujud diantaranya adalah harga, jasa, layanan, kualitas, dan lain sebagainya. Bapak, Ibu sekalian, ladies and gentlemen, today I'm glad to welcome our speakers today that is going to give more information both in theory and practice, especially in agri-food industry. And here they are. So, Mas Ervan, do I have slide for this? Apakah ada slide untuk memperkenalkan ini? If it is not, then okay. So, I'm glad to welcome Miss Dr. Juwaida Syarifuddin as our first speaker here. She is a senior lecturer from University Putra Malaysia. Miss Juwaida Syarifuddin or Dr. Juwaida Syarifuddin has PhD from Cardiff University, UK, Master of Business Administration from UPM, and also Bachelor degree in Business Administration from Drexel University, USA. She has been a senior lecturer since from September 2011 until now. And her current expertise atau keahlian beliau is in international agribusiness marketing, agribusiness management and marketing, research methods, strategic management. Besides, as a senior lecturer, she also has been involved in consultancy and advisory services in a national and international level. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was Miss Dr. Juwaida Syarifuddin. We are very glad to invite you here. That was our first speaker, and now I would like to introduce you to our second speaker. This session is Mr. Ahmad Syakban Nasution. Inginnya dipanggil Mas Ahmad ya, gitu ya. Jangan Pak ya, because he is still young ya. So, beliau adalah seorang lulusan Teknik Sipil Universitas Brawijaya yang berbisnis makanan ya. So, ini yang mudah-mudahan nggak boleh kalah ya Anda dengan Bapak Syakban Nasution ya. And then his business is Ailani Food, CV Ailani Food ya, and also Jagoan Indonesia as the co-founder. For Ailani Food has been established from 2010 until now, while Jagoan Indonesia is from 2018 until now. So he has so many business experience in term of food industry, especially for mushroom, the dalam bahasa Indonesianya adalah jamur, ya. Yeah. And also he is famous as a coach, ya, yeah, atau seorang pelatih, ya. Yeah. And then that was all of our speaker today. So ladies and gentlemen, Miss Juwaida would be speaking in term of theory for today, and it will be continued with Mr. Ahmad Syakban Nasution. Panitia, silahkan ditutup dulu. And I would like to give time for Dr. Juwaida Syarifuddin for your presentation. Please, time is yours.
Okay, thank you very much, Bu Novi. Assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon to everybody. Now I will share my slide first. Okay. Can you see the slides?
Yes, yes, okay. We can see your slide.
All right. So I will speak in English because our bahasa is sometimes different words, okay? So my contribution to this webinar for today is on the theory or model on customer value propositions. So I will basically look at what is the use of value proposition for agro-food entrepreneurs. Right now, I'm in Department of Agribusiness and Bioresource Economics, Faculty of Agriculture, University Putra Malaysia. So the first is definition, okay? Definition is on customer value proposition is the one that you promise to deliver to customers. Apa yang dijanjikan untuk diberi kepada pelanggan so that they know what they can get from you as compared to the competitors, because pesaingnya ramai di dalam pasaran. So how do the customers choose which one that they want to buy? Okay, the most important thing is that they will part with their money, they will give to you and buy your product or services. Okay, so the value proposition that you want to tell them, it be communicated directly to them. That means it's not only they know about your product, but they have to understand, they have to they can see it, okay, and then they know the differences between your product and services as compared to the competitors. Okay. Now, why do you need to have customer value proposition? Is because it will give the company, your company, direction to go, to focus on, so that you always will remember what is it that your product, what is it serve the purpose for the customers, okay? And then it will also bring confidence to the seller themselves. That means it will bring confidence to you and your staff, pekerja dalam company. And also it will bring confidence to the customers who are going to buy your product. Okay. And also customer will understand about your product. It's easier for them to ask. It's easier for you to explain to them, okay? And it's going to have message that is message clarity. That means senang difahami, okay, oleh pelanggan. And also, it will make your marketing advertising, for example, or promotion, it will increase the effectiveness of your marketing activities. So that is something that is beneficial of the company by looking at customer value proposition. So how do you want to find your customer value proposition? First, you look at your brand, okay? You look at your product. And then you compare with your competitors. And then you have to look at what consumer wants. So that means three things. Tiga benda yang you have to look at to determine what the things that you are going to produce for the customers, okay? Now, if you look at this, we will see that the green one is here between you and the customers, okay? So we will look at what is this? What does this mean? The blue, the red, and the yellow. Ini seperti traffic light, ya? Okay? Yeah. Now, the green one is the winning zone because this is where you can serve the consumer. You can serve what they wanted to have from the seller, okay? If you are looking at what your competitor does well and what the consumer wants, that is nothing to do with you because it is outside of what you can offer to the consumer. So you don't need to look at this, okay? Why do you you are not supposed to look at the yellow zone is because you are also producing it, the competitors are also producing it. So that means you are clashing with the competitors to get to what the consumer wants. So it's dangerous, okay, for you to do that, or you have to fork extra money to make sure that your product is better than the competitors. Now, if you look at the blue area is what you are producing, what the competitors are producing. It doesn't match the consumer ones. So, why do you need to focus your attention to this area? Okay, so that's why the best thing that you would like to focus on is the green area, okay, the winning zone. So what is the value? Okay, value of the customers, okay, equals to benefit minus cost. So what are the benefits that you can give based on your product and services minus all the costs by the consumers? So what can the consumer get from your product? Might be good brand. When they are using your brand, it brings certain image to the consumer. It can solve their problem. The experience is very nice by using your product. Maybe they are loyal customers to you. The quality of your product is tip-top. So that are the benefits that they can have by using your product. Now, what are the costs? The cost includes, of course, the money, okay? The money that they have to pay to you to use that product or service. Other than that, might be time, effort. For example, if they have to go to your shop about 1 hour away from their house. So that is an effort, including the cost, the money that they have to pay for your product, okay? The convenience, whether it's easy for them or not. Easy meaning might be easy to use or easy for them to substitute from the current product that they have been using, okay? So poor experience, these are all the costs that you need to think about when you want them to change and use your product. So how to increase customer value? These are some of the tips. That means when the customers have used your product, you evaluate their experience, whether you need to modify something or you need to offer more good experience when they are using your product. For example, if your product is the expensive ones and it comes with service warranty. Might be they really like your product. It's just that it's too long for them to send their product back for a service, or if something broken, they have to add more, and it's expensive for them to get your product for service. So that will reduce the number of customers that will go back to you to buy more products. Okay, so you focus more than price. It's not like people are not willing to pay high price. Okay, some of them are willing to pay high price, but might be other things that you can focus on. For example, like the ones I said just now, image, or it is a good brand. Might be when they have to pay for a lot for your product, you include services, free service, for example, for 1 year or 2 years. So these are some of the things that you can add to make the customers feel better about your product. Okay, might be you can collect customer data, and by using that data, you go and do some research to see what else can you do to increase their happiness about your product. Okay, you can also look at loyal customers. Yes, they are loyal. So hopefully they don't run away to your competitors, but then you have to know how to retain them, okay? So that they always be with you. And like I've those who have taken my class before, I always talk about segmenting your customers. That means you target some different groups of customers. Okay, now. This is actually very important, okay, in value proposition, whereby you look at the customer, okay? You look at the customers, what are the things that they have to do, right? This is the customer jobs. And then when they want to do this job, what are the pains? That means what are the problems that they face when they want to do their work, or they want to do some of the things that they are doing, okay? And then what do they want? The one not been achieved. So you are looking at these three things from the customer side, okay? Then you look at your own company, okay? For your own company, looking at the things that they have to, the consumers have to do, and what their problems are, what are the pain reliever. That means ubat apa yang boleh diberi. That means what can you offer the consumers so that they can solve their problem, okay? And then look at what they can gain by using your product, okay? Then you will look at what are the things that you can offer to the consumer. So this fit between these two, from the consumers and also from the company's side, that will give you the fit, okay? So that they will connect with your company and they will buy your product, okay? Because you can solve their problem by using the product that you produce. So we will look at one example, okay? For example, Sally in her 20s, okay, just graduated. So she got jobs at the city center. She doesn't earn that much, okay? But then she wants to be healthy, but she doesn't know how to cook. Tak reti masak, ya? Okay? So usually, she just buy fast food, okay? So we look at the customer side. What she needs is to get meals easily, so untuk mudah makan, okay, and at affordable price. Fast food is unhealthy. Untuk memasak expensive. Untuk membeli dari restoran expensive. Jadi unhealthy lifestyle for her, okay. So, but then by buying, it gives money for her, okay, so that she can buy other things. And then belian fast food, meaning she doesn't have to wait too long, okay, to get food to eat. So what can you, from your side, offer? Okay, you can produce healthy meals for working class customer, okay, and you can have affordable packages. That means boleh dibeli, all right? It's not expensive. So gains that you can give to the customers is that you can use low packages, okay, so that customers don't have to pay very expensive for it, and you can also deliver the meal to the customers either to their home or to their office. So that means all these can solve the problem for the customers. So what can you produce is daily subscription-based meal service for working class customer. That means it's tailored to the customers themselves. They can choose what they want to eat. It can be packaged and you can send to them. So these are the match, the fit you can do by having this value proposition canvas. Okay. Now we look at the other one, COVID-19 tours. Okay, after COVID-19, tourism is the effect to tourism is very high. Okay. So for the customer, from the customer's point of view, ini customer yang suka berjalan ya, suka go to other countries. Okay. So he cannot go to other countries. He cannot support the economy because we have COVID-19. So it's really a problem for this person because it has to go to be at home 24 hours, 7 days a week. Kena duduk rumah sahaja. And then cannot support the economy because he cannot spend his money to help the companies, tourism companies. Okay. Also, the children are very bored at home. Okay. So Gaines, he wants to achieve his dream to go to other countries. Okay. So what the company can provide? This company can provide fun for the whole family. Okay. What they can offer is virtual guided tours. That means it's from home. You don't have to go out from your house. You can pay the company, and then they will have somebody to serve as your guide. Okay, it's not only watching video. You can always ask them, and they can answer. That's the possibility to talk with experienced guides, and then possibility you can meet with other people in groups. For example, because kalau kita pergi melancong di negara lain, in one bus, for example, 40 people, we will meet other people, okay? So might be using this virtual guided tours, you can also spend time or make talk, small talks with other people, okay? So that enrich your experience. So this is the fit between the consumer and also the company, okay? So what you need to look at is the market, okay? Which market that you are targeting, what value that you want to give to the consumer. Usually it has to look at the consumer, what they understand about your product and what value do they give to your product, okay? And then look at the offerings, the one that you are selling to them. What are the benefits that you can give to the consumer? And you have to communicate that benefit to the consumers, okay? How does it different from the competitor's product, okay? So that is to make sure that you have distinctive benefit as compared to the competitors. If possible, find proof. Ini testimoni, okay? Proof sales apa ni? How many sales can you make in a month? For example, that can be your proof to show potential customer that your product is good. Okay, so to, I think Malaysia is also like Indonesia. If you give that testimony, you ask some of the of your loyal customers to tell their experience when they use your product. That one usually it will be one of the factor to make potential customers go and buy your product. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 6, value proposition builder framework. Okay. So it's very important for you to know your target customer, okay, and connect with your customer. At the same time, you study your competitors, look at what they are offering and what can you offer that are different from them, okay? Differentiate your product, okay, as compared to the competitors. Dispel myths and stereotypes. Sometimes people say that people have certain perceptions about certain food. For example, makan ubi kayu nanti angin ya, kembung, kembung perut. So that is myth. But try to make sure that your might be your product is different. So if people eat your bingka ubi or your product, they will not have that problem, for example lah, okay? And then have clear mission statement. This is for especially for your staff, okay? Clear-cut benefits. You have to promise. And when you promise, that means you have to deliver, okay? Ini yang sebenarnya ramai yang takut nak buat. Companies don't want to give to promise anything because they are afraid that they cannot deliver their promise. Okay, but if you after this, we will look at some examples on how you promise your customers. Okay, speak the language of your customer. Jangan guna bahasa yang susah-susah. Okay, make sure that people can understand. Alright. If your target customer, the level of education is low, so gunakan bahasa yang mudah, okay? Maximize credibility, substantiate, that means jangan sampai review on your product tu banyak yang negatif. Baru ada credibility untuk product you, so that other people are more they are going to trust. They have high trust when they want to buy your product. Okay, this is especially for expensive products lah. Okay, and then seek tanya pada sesiapa yang sudah successful. Okay, go and learn from successful players in the market. So it's going to benefit you. And those who are successful, hopefully they are also going to share their knowledge, like Mas Ahmad, yeah. Mas Ahmad also a trainer. So a trainer, that means you always share your experience, okay? And focus on the customer and not the business process. For example, if the customer wants something and it's going to be hard for you, don't focus on the hardship of your company. Do whatever that you can to fulfill the customer needs. The one that on the business side, that one is for you to take off. Okay, so this one is some of the unique selling proposition. For example, for the customer, from the customer side, anak lapar ya, tapi mak dan ayah tak mau masak, penat, okay, sudah penat. So the unique selling point for Domino's pizza is fresh hot pizza delivered in 30 minutes or it's free. Jadi itu dah ada janji di situ. Barang yang sampai, barang makanan yang sampai, pizza itu mestilah fresh dan panas lagi. Dan kalau tidak sampai dalam 30 minutes, the next buy is going to be free. Okay, you don't have to pay for it. Okay, so that is janji yang dibuat by Domino's Pizza. Okay, and this one, I have also received a number of free pizza because they cannot give me in 30 minutes. Okay, masalahnya in Malaysia we have heavy rain, kan? Kita ada heavy rains and some of sometimes seperti mau Ramadan. In Ramadan untuk berbuka puasa, that means everybody is buying at the same time. But the company, because of they have the promises, they have to find ways how to cook during the peak hour, okay? Like in Ramadan, okay? FedEx, I have to get this package delivered quick. This is from the consumers, okay? So what FedEx janji, okay, the promise is it will be there overnight. That means satu malam saja, and the product will be at the at the place the next day, okay? Jadi dia kena fulfill that, right? I have sent one package to UK before by using FedEx, and from the moment I send to, it goes from one place to another place, 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, dia ada keep track, okay? And then by the next day, memang benda tu sampai kepada the ones that I intend to send that package. So memang dia, that is the promise by FedEx. Okay, FedEx ni, tulisan ni, even ada arrow di sini. Okay, so arrow ni is to deliver. Okay, so it's also in their logo. Okay, they put that. Candy industry, you have problems when you eat chocolate, it melts in your hand. So what M&M said is that the milk, the chocolate will melt in your mouth, dalam mulut ya, bukannya dalam tangan. So that is the promise. And they make sure that even if you hold the chocolate for 10 minutes, it's not going to melt in your hand. Okay? So that this is example for Western companies. Okay, this is also Western companies. Look at the three competitor in coffee restaurants. Okay, coffee drinks. Yeah. So all of these are telling that they are selling premium coffees, but Coffee Bean, it has something else, which is they have the finest and rarest loose leaf teas. That means they also have tea. That's why dalam brand logo pun ada coffee bean and tea leaf. Okay, yang lain tak ada. But all of them are selling premium coffee. Okay, but how Starbucks want to differentiate itself from the other two? So they said that they are going to offer to inspire and nurture the human spirit, one person, one cup, and one neighborhood at a time. So that means it says that the environment, they also promise that the environment will be different when you drink in Starbucks. Okay, so they promise coffee drinking and sharing lifestyle. So they promise about coffee beverages, they promise nice environment, and they promise on friendly staff. So when they are taking new staff, the way they train the staff, they have to know and understand and remember all these three. When you are working in Starbucks, you have to make sure that coffee is good, okay? And then environment is nice. You have to always clean everything and make sure that the atmosphere is good for the customers. And everybody has to be friendly. That's why when you go to Starbucks, dari you buka pintu, terus, welcome to Starbucks. Selamat pagi, selamat sore. Okay, so they make sure that they smile to everybody. Okay, to all the customers. They have to do that. Okay, so that is because they promised as a brand. Okay, this brand, Publix, they is promising that they help feed local families. That means they make sure that local families in the local area will receive the wholesome food, okay, for everybody. So this is the brand promise that they have. Now, this one is Malaysian example, okay? We have Adabi. Adabi is selling spices, okay? So spices that we have, curry, and then this one is new, apa ya panggil, jemput-jemput. It's a kind of, it's not dessert, it's something that you eat with tea in the evening, okay? And then this one is ready mix lah, okay, pre-mix. And then you have untuk soup, untuk tom yum, so the spices, okay. But the promise is it's sajian istana di zaman silam. That means it has to be something that is fit to be served to the kings. So they will try as much as they can to make sure that all the raw materials, the ingredients that they use is high quality to make sure that it can be served to the king. Okay, so they use this tagline, and in their advertisement, they always put that, and people always feel that when they are buying Adabi spices and products, they will get the best. Okay, in the market. So this is one of the SME in Malaysia that is already successful. And the other one is Farm Fresh. Farm Fresh is producing fresh milk. As you know, Malaysia does not produce that much milk, fresh milk. So this is one of the companies that are very successful now, like in the last 5 years. Okay. So what they promise is that in 48 hours, the milk will be from the cow to the consumer in 48 hours. So that means their milk is fresher than the ones that is in the market that we imported from Australia, from New Zealand, and from other countries. So they want to show that they milk for the consumers, Malaysian consumers. So this is the micro companies. What you can see is that this one is for honey, okay? From stingless bee honey. This one is Agrofarm. So what you can see is that they cannot promise too much. They cannot differentiate their product as compared to other people, but at least they are trying. Okay, at least they can say, they can tell to the consumers what they are selling. Okay, for this one, they are selling fish and seafood, but if you buy from them, it's already washed and cleaned and cut, and then they package properly, and then they will send from Kuala Selangor. Kuala Selangor ni is the place where the fishermen will put their fresh fish, Okay, and then they send this fish and seafood to Klang Valley, which is sometimes 1 hour away from Kuala Selangor, one and a half hours away. So and they charge only RM5 delivery anywhere in Klang Valley. If it is 2 hours away, RM5 delivery is not make sense. But because they have promised, they know how to make sure that they have a good number of delivery every day so that they can go everywhere, and then it costs, they can only charge RM5 for each person. Okay, so it does not cost the buyer RM30, RM35 for each order. Okay, so that is what they are doing now. Kika ni is it offers the services after COVID-19, because previously we don't buy, not many people buy from seller seafood that has been cleaned and processed and sent to your house. Usually we want to go and pilih sendiri ya, seafood, fresh seafood. But now because of COVID-19 and now we cannot go out again, so this kind of service is very, very demanded, okay, by the customers. So this is actually what I have to say about value propositions. Okay, so hopefully we can hear from the industry player, from Mas Ahmad. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the presentation, Dr. Juwaida Sharifuddin. And ladies and gentlemen, now let's move on to the next presenter, that is Mr. Ahmad Syahban Nasution. He will be speaking about the customer value proposition in agro-industry viewpoints. Hello, Mas Ahmad, ada di sini, Mas Ahmad? So I think he is still having a trouble, punya permasalahan dalam jaringan ya. Kita sedang menunggu Pak Ahmad Syahban Nasution. And while we were waiting for Mr. Ahmad, yeah, we have already learned so many things. I wish to give you the concluding remarks later ya, tetapi mungkin di sini tadi kita sudah mempelajari that value, customer value proposition is a message that you want your product to have so that the customer will be able to membeli ya dan menikmati produknya. Oke, bagaimana panitia, Pak Ahmad Nasution, sudah ada? So if we will be waiting for Mr. Ahmad Syahban Nasution, Mas Ervan and friends. And now mungkin kita melihat Q&A dulu ya dari from the group chat. And then we have Priscilla Teresia Silalahi, who Juwaida, maybe you can comment on her question. I'm going to read. Saya akan membacakan. She's a reseller, yeah. So she doesn't have an original product. So walaupun demikian, yeah. So how can I make a value proposition, even though she is only a reseller, so that she can compete with other resellers? Okay.
Thank you for that question, Priscilla. Okay. Now, if you are a reseller, that means you cannot change the product. But what I can see reseller in Malaysia, what they do is they offer different services. For example, there are reseller that gives you a chance to pay twice or pay three times when you buy from them. That means dia bagi hutang. Okay. Yes. Ataupun there are also reseller that will stay with the customer and give advice. For example, this one is for barang seperti skincare. Okay. So they will ask you your problem and they will suggest what product that you can buy if they have different types of product. Okay. Another types of service that you can give as reseller is cash on delivery, for example. Sometimes you want to make sure that you receive the money first before you send the product, okay? But that one, the customer have to transfer online, for example, or pay first before they can get the product. So what you can do is, if there are no reseller that goes to that area, you say that you can offer to send the product to that area, and then they can pay you cash when you deliver your product. So might be the value is not from the product itself, but what are additional service that you can give to the customers.
Okay, thank you for your answer. Maybe ada yang mau raise hand, yang mau menyampaikan langsung. You want to introduce yourself live. Sebentar lagi ya, but I'm going to read you the second question. So this is from YouTube, from Ida Sakmadi Dewi Purwanisari. As explained earlier about we have seek value proposition. Builder network, yeah. Is there any other way to give proof to our customer, especially for new business? So Dr. Juwaida, how about new business or a startup? Because
you don't have proof yet.
Mm-hmm. We don't have testimony or proof yet.
Okay. This is where you have to you have to keluarkan cost sikit, capital sikit. That means you go and have to give free to a few people for them to try. So that after they try, then they can give testimony. So that is something yang, if you cannot afford to do advertisement, try to do this to get, you know, and then bit by bit, when one person give testimony, might be two of his friend want to buy, and then these two person buy, and then they will create more more customer that wants to buy. So this is where we don't know any artist kan, but we have social media right now where you have people who have followers. So you go and go to this kind of people that have high followers, try asking them to get the taste of your product, and then hopefully if they can give good testimony, it will increase the number of people that wants to buy your product, want to try to buy and taste your product. If you cannot go to the people with high number of followers, then you try like that. You don't have that much money. So you try to give ketua kampung. You find somebody who is who can influence other people. Maybe cikgu, teachers at school. You know, they have their circle of friends. So to one or two people, and then they will tell good things about your product, that is good already. So try to begin like that. Might be it can help.
Yes. So it means that the power of word of mouth. Yeah. So when you want to buy something, maybe you want to ask a suggestion from your family, your friends. Yeah, I hope that answer your question, Made. Yeah, thank you, Miss Dr. Juwaida, for the answer. Now, is Mas Ahmad already here with us? Mas Ahmad, hello. Okay. Belum ya, Mas Ervan?
Tadi sudah join, Bu, tapi
reconnect.
Keluar lagi karena gangguan sinyal sepertinya.
Ya, ya, enggak apa-apa. Okay. Yeah, we will still have a Q&A with Dr. Juwaida, and after that I would like you to prepare. We have a special presentation product from students, okay? Later on, after one more question, this is from a lecturer of Brawijaya University. Mr. Junaidi, are you here, Mr. Junaidi? Yes.
So yes, Mr. Junaidi, yes, yes, but Kunofi, hello.
Ask with live on live streaming, please. Silakan.
Yes, Kunofi.
Yeah. Okay. Would you mind to deliver your question?
Well, actually, I have typed it on the chat facilities. I've got two question for Dr. Juwaida. Sometimes as a entrepreneur, I mean the beginner, when we want to start our business, there are two questions. The first is where we start our business. I mean, dari mana bisnis besar itu dimulai, gitu? Karena kita ingin bisnis kita menjadi besar. Kemudian the second question, how to create supplier and customer base for our business, because the role of supplier and customer base is really important with regard to our business sustainability. Thank you.
Thank you very much for Mr. Junaidi for delivering the question live. And now we have two question. Dari mana bisnis besar itu dimulai? And then second one is how to create suppliers and customer base for our business. Dr. Juwaida, please.
Okay. Jika dilihat untuk bisnis yang besar, usually it starts small. From the entrepreneur. Then as time goes by, the demand keep increasing, then you get a bigger factory or you produce more, that will increase your production. And you for example, like Adabi before this, starts from very small company producing only for the Kabupaten, okay? But it's now a very big company and it can export also to other countries. So it depends on how well the consumer received your product, okay? And also we are trying to, the government, Malaysian government, try to increase, speed up the process from small company to bigger company. So when the government wants to help to make this company bigger, then it needs to give a certain help, such as machineries or capital or match with the, we have one ministry that goes to other countries, and whoever that wants to find another company in Malaysia, this ministry will match the company in another country with the Malaysian company, so that they can do business after that. So this is some of the things yang dibuat di Malaysia. So this can make the company increase in size. So these types of helps are also given in certain industry. Okay. Untuk supplier dengan customer, memang it's up to the company to determine which customer that they want to serve, and then with the quality of the product that they want to produce, who are the supplier that will they will choose to supply the raw materials to them. So it is up to the business itself on a selection of supplier and customers.
Okay, we hope that it answers your question, Dr. Junaidi. Thank you for your participation. And now
thank you very
we
much.
Have our second speaker. Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Mr. Junaidi. We have Mr. Ahmad Nasution here that is going to give a talk in terms of agro-industry. Okay, the time is yours.
Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Junaidi. How are you, Dr. Juwaida? I start to share the content, okay? Okay, everybody. Semoga semua sehat. I'm so sorry. Now I'm in rural. Saya sedang di sebuah pedesaan di Karanganyar di Jawa Tengah. Sometimes the signal is lag. Jadi kadang tadi saya beberapa kali putus. Saya mohon maaf. Semoga kali ini tidak putus. Oke, okay, saya akan mencoba memulai. I try to share my experience for maybe 10 years become an entrepreneur. So my name is Ahmad Nasution. I'm an entrepreneur. But yeah, I think it's still a SME, a small medium enterprise, UKM ya kalau di Indonesia. I'm a founder of Ailani Food. I'm a co-founder of Jago Indonesia. Jago Indonesia is like a creative consultant for UMKM ya, SME. And I'm a founder and chief on Fulcon Communication, on my new business. So I'm in Karanganyar for business for Fulcon Communication. Okay, let's get started. So this some history of Ailani Food. So we start at 2010. 10 years ago, and our first product is abon jamur, mushroom floss. Jadi kadang orang melihat abon itu dari daging, so we produce abon from mushroom, oyster mushroom floss. And now alhamdulillah we produce very good quality and healthy product. This is some of our timeline for Ailani Food. So in 2010, we produced abon jamur. 2013, we made fruited chip, keripik buah, yeah. In 2014, we made daily granola. And 2017, daily smoothies. And this year, we try a new business. Saya akan menjelaskan nanti di belakang ya. Jadi dari beberapa tahun kami berjalan, ada beberapa hal yang sudah kami lakukan gitu ya. Tapi for the first time, I will try to explain about abon jamur. Why abon jamur gitu ya. Jadi di tahun 2010, we try to produce abon jamur. Saya yakin kalau abon jamur kami the first in Indonesia, pertama di Indonesia ya. Dan it makes proud of me ya. Saya sangat bangga mungkin karena saya masih sangat muda waktu itu. 27 tadi. Dan mungkin jadi anak muda yang idealis ya. Jadi menjadi yang pertama itu adalah hal yang keren, it's cool to be the first in the industry. Apalagi waktu itu kami membuat satu hal yang baru ya, yang tidak pernah ada sebelumnya, abon jamur gitu ya. Karena in Indonesian market, plus mean meat, beef, or chicken meat, gitu ya. Jadi kalau tiba-tiba muncul ada abon jamur, itu hal yang breakthrough gitu kalau menurut seorang anak muda bernama Ahmad Nasution waktu itu ya. Baik, kami sudah berjalan 10 tahun, so this our packaging design, abon jamur kami ada beberapa varian, there's egg Korean, the original one, the vegetarian, and with flavor. Ini adalah design, the design yang we develop maybe the fourth generation ya, design yang keempat gitu ya, design yang keempat sejak kami memulainya di tahun 2010. Di awal kami memulainya dengan design yang sangat sederhana. Dulu kami membuat dengan plastik biasa, mungkin kalau yang di Malang knows with a plastic like tempe chip, tempe chip dan apa kemasan tempe chip gitu ya. Tapi kami terus berkembang gitu ya. Okay. But okay, we learn a lot from abon jamur, blood and soul. Benar-benar berdarah-darah teman-teman. Jadi di tahun 2010 mungkin sampai tahun 2012 itu benar-benar berat banget ya. Very tough period. Maybe because saya terlalu optimis gitu ya. Terlalu optimis, saya terlalu bangga gitu dengan sebuah produk yang mungkin tidak pernah ada gitu ya, tanpa memikirkan banyak hal lainnya. Tapi ini adalah jalan yang menarik karena akhirnya saya bisa belajar otodidak tentang bisnis lebih banyak lagi melalui abon jamur, dan menjadi dasar saya bisa membuat produk-produk kami yang lainnya. Oke, coba saya jelaskan ya. Why is blood and tears? Because product was great, but we don't know who's gonna buy and how they will buy. Jadi kadangkala di Indonesia ya terutama ya, a lot of people they are very good in make product ya, yeah, but they don't know who's gonna buy. Itu yang terjadi pada saya 10 tahun yang lalu gitu ya. Jadi buat produk sekeren mungkin, as cool as possible, as delicious as possible, that sometimes we forget about who's gonna buy and how they will buy. So I learned a lot. So dari abon jamur saya dapat banyak hal ya. Saya dapat banyak hal. Saya pikir kita harus belajar tentang we must be honest about our product. What the good, what the bad about our product, apa kelebihannya, apa kekurangannya, what is our product exactly market, marketnya siapa, gitu ya, kita mau jualan barang ini kepada siapa, our product value fit to the market and product positioning in market. Jadi, kadang kita itu selalu bertanya, kalau ada yang bertanya, who's your market? Everyone. Saya menjawab everyone, saya rasa itu menjadi sulit nantinya. Itu akan become sulit untuk market yang tepat. Karena ternyata tidak semua orang bisa kita puaskan gitu ya dengan produk kita. Gitu. Jadi kita harus punya market yang benar-benar tepat. Gitu ya. Mungkin sama seperti yang disampaikan oleh Dr. Jiaida tadi, market. Gitu. Alhamdulillah. A couple months ago, Ibu Novi and friends come to my place and talk about business and her research, ya. Dan alhamdulillah ini ada beberapa hasil dari research yang dilakukan oleh Ibu Novi dan teman berupa business model canvas. I'm sorry jika ada typo salah penulisan. Oke, okay. Ini kalau saya bacakan semua akan memotong waktu sangat lama, tapi intinya bahwa yang kami lakukan in the right line ya. Jadi tapi ini adalah penelitian sebelum pandemi gitu ya. Saya terima kasih banyak buat Bu Novi. Dan ini juga ada hasil penelitian untuk plot strateginya before outbreak. Okay, before outbreak. Jadi kalau lihat dari hasilnya ini bagus banget mungkin ya menurut saya, karena opportunity and strength-nya posisinya di kuadran yang kanan atas gitu ya. Lalu mungkin ada beberapa hasil penelitian beliau itu, yang pertama adalah optimizing the using of digital marketing, optimizing marketing strategy and penetration, open partnership with win-win solution. The research mungkin sekarang akan berubah karena sudah ada the pandemic ya, pandemi mengubah segalanya gitu. Jadi namun karena kami sudah punya banyak pengalaman saat memulai Abon Jamur, maka produk-produk kami berikutnya kami mencoba, we try to start from market. Jadi we don't develop a product, but we searching what market need. Jadi kalau teman-teman mahasiswa bisa melakukan dua hal sebenarnya, memulai dari market dulu atau dari produk dulu. Paling gampang dari produk, the easy way, but akan lebih sulit menjalankannya ke depan gitu ya. Tapi kalau if we search what market need, menurut saya akan lebih mudah saat kita develop the product-nya. Jadi after we develop Abon Jamur, the next product we try to research the market gitu ya. Jadi saya coba sedikit bercerita. Oke, ini jadi ini tadi. Mungkin sama seperti same with the Dr. Juwaida explanation, market research start with market pain. Jadi setelah itu kami mencoba mencari apa sebenarnya, what the market pain, apa yang jadi masalah di masyarakat, apa yang jadi penyakit di masyarakat, gitu ya. Kita kumpulkan data-datanya. So we learn about data, we learn about behavior of people. Then after market research, we got it. Ini some example. When we start to develop daily granola, superfood from grain, a lot of grain, very sangat sehat ya. Research kami adalah di Kota Malang, we live in Malang, healthy life growth fast in big city, young family increase, middle up income, young mother need new way of breastfeeding booster, healthy food product with expensive price, and people care about their body. Jadi diet gitu ya. That diet sounds like another problem. Jadi kami menemukan beberapa hal gitu ya. Jadi gaya hidup sehat itu bertumbuh sangat pesat di kota besar. Mungkin beberapa penyebabnya adalah banyak orang yang lupa waktu akan kerja misalnya ya. Everyone mengejar sesuatu gitu ya. Mungkin untuk mendapatkan uang mungkin, atau untuk bisa membeli sesuatu gitu ya. Terus kelas menengah juga berkembang juga di Indonesia. Begitu juga dengan karena mungkin suami istri mereka harus bekerja, mungkin anak-anaknya juga butuh asupan ASI yang baik gitu ya, maka mereka membutuhkan cara baru untuk menyusui anak-anaknya ya, mereka butuh sesuatu yang bisa lebih menyenangkan. Dan yang menarik lagi adalah saat mereka mulai berpikir tentang hidup sehat, healthy life, in other side, healthy food products too expensive ya, cukup mahal gitu. Di mungkin karena bahan-bahan bakunya mungkin tidak terlalu umum di pasaran, sehingga nanti biaya produksi juga akan meningkat gitu. Dari market research ini kita coba membuat obatnya gitu ya, medicine-nya. Jadi seperti kalau sakit kepala berarti mungkin obatnya apa gitu ya. Jadi sederhana seperti itu. Maka yang kami dapatkan adalah kami mencoba untuk membuat granola. Kenapa granola gitu ya? Why granola? Because at the time my wife lagi hamil anak kedua ya. Anak sudah melahirkan anak kedua dan searching for breastfeeding booster gitu, ASI booster yang menyenangkan gitu ya. Kalau di Indonesia itu ada minum daun katuk misalnya ya, mungkin itu terlalu old, traditional way gitu ya. Jadi kita mencari the modern one gitu. Jadi kita berpikir bagaimana dengan granola gitu ya. Granola. Dari di yang kami dapatkan dari granola biasanya itu memang harganya cukup mahal kalau di dan tersedia hanya di premium supermarket gitu. Di premium supermarket dan harganya mahal dan biasanya kemasannya bisa with big size gitu ya dan harganya mahal. Akhirnya kemampuan membeli jadi terhambat gitu ya. Jadi kita coba buat sesuatu yang bisa menjawab itu. Jadi kita membuat daily granola dengan whole grain, jadi kandungan dari biji-bijiannya itu semakin banyak, lebih murah tanpa penambahan gula. Kemasannya praktis karena kita membuat kemasan kecil di limit 125 gram ya. 125 gram gitu dalam satu kemasan. Kita buat tagline yang menarik dan variannya kita buat lebih banyak. Jadi bukan hanya satu atau dua, kami buat sampai lima varian gitu ya. Jadi kalau di pasaran itu produk granola itu rata-rata imported from Australia or other countries. Jadi harganya cukup mahal, satu kemasan mungkin 400 gram atau mungkin 500 gram bisa sampai 100.000 lebih. Maka kami buat kemasan 125 gram dengan harga cuma Rp25.000 gitu ya. Rp25.000 biji-bijinya lebih banyak, harganya lebih murah, lebih sehat gitu ya, dan lebih banyak lagi yang kita dapatkan di situ. So when we develop our product based on market need, we have enough space to develop value proposition product that fit with our market. Jadi kita lebih mudah, kita tidak meraba-raba, kita sudah tahu. We know what market needs. Jadi akan lebih mudah produk kita akan diterima oleh pasar. Itu yang kami lakukan. Nah, saat kita mendevelop daily granola, kita dapat lebih banyak data lagi. We got a lot of data about healthy food behavior in Malang, especially at Malang. Dan kami mendapatkan banyak data bahwa ternyata yang dibutuhkan itu bukan hanya sekedar granola, mereka juga butuh makanan yang bukan hanya untuk diet, tapi juga untuk benar-benar membuat mereka jauh lebih sehat, lebih enak badannya dan lain-lain ya. So akhirnya we try in 2017 we try to develop other product ya. Jadi kami mencoba bukan membuat satu produk, tapi membuat lebih banyak produk dengan konsep berbeda gitu ya. Jadi di tahun 2017 kita mencoba membuat yang namanya daily smoothies gitu ya. Daily smoothies, jadi dari namanya smoothies, minuman sehat dari buah-buahan ya gitu. Dan kita buat beberapa tagline, one stop healthy food solution. Jadi konsepnya adalah ghost kitchen. Ghost kitchen itu biasanya berlaku untuk resto online gitu ya, karena kami benar-benar 100% online with 130 menu. Mungkin sambil dengar my explanation bisa follow Instagramnya Daily Smoothies. Marketnya adalah middle market increase in Malang dan healthy life issues. Jadi ini menarik saat kita mencari data konsumen waktu memulai granola di tahun 2014, kami sambil berjalan kami mendapatkan lebih banyak data lagi gitu ya. Jadi data yang kami dapatkan dari konsumen kita itu bukan hanya granola. Mereka kadang menanyakan tentang cold pressed juice, they talk about salad, they talk about smoothies, they talk about almond milk. Akhirnya di tahun 2017 kita mencoba membuat sesuatu yang berbeda gitu ya. We tried something new, kita membuat sesuatu yang berbeda dengan konsep ghost kitchen concept. Jadi kita menyiapkan sekitar 130 menu ya yang dibutuhkan, dan ini tidak langsung 130 menu di awal memulai ya di 2017, tapi saat ini kita sudah memiliki 130 menu. Jadi benar-benar seperti restoran tapi online gitu ya, dan menyediakan makanan-makanan sehat. Dan kami menjanjikan like Dr. Gia said, we promise it is cheaper and it is organic ya. Jadi kami benar-benar mencoba bahan-bahan yang kami buat itu sebagian besar adalah bahan-bahan organik gitu. Karena di Malang percentage-nya, karena di Malang banyak tempat yang memang organic farm gitu ya. Jadi kami bekerja sama dengan beberapa organic farm untuk menghasilkan produk-produk yang organik, sehat, dan tentunya bisa jauh lebih murah. Kenapa? Karena kadang some people think that the organic vegetable expensive because they buy it in a premium supermarket gitu loh. Jadi kita mencoba memberikan sesuatu yang sebenarnya bisa lebih murah daripada yang banyak orang pikirkan gitu ya. Jadi banyak orang pikirkan, tapi ya oke, okay, it made education for market menyampaikan bahwa ini benar-benar organik. Di masa outbreak ini, karena kita dapat lagi data-data lagi yang baru dan kita sudah bekerja sama dengan beberapa organic farm, kita sedang mendevelop yang namanya dapur antar. Dapur antar ini menyediakan sayur-sayuran organik yang murah dan terjangkau, gitu ya. Murah dan terjangkau, bukan hanya sayur-sayuran tapi bahan-bahan lain juga. Jadi raw materialnya juga kita coba kumpulkan. Ini masih dalam proses developing ya. Datanya sudah kita kumpulkan, sekarang lagi proses developing, namanya dapur antar. Silakan bisa di-follow juga mungkin ya untuk dapur antar yang kami akan segera kami launching ini. Baik. Banyak yang bertanya pada saya mengenai bagaimana saat kondisi pandemi gitu ya, kondisi pandemi. Di kondisi pandemi, Deli Smoothies mengalami acceleration ya, jadi akselerasi yang luar biasa. Kita naik 3 kali lipat dari sebelumnya, because the outbreak makes people they think about healthy. How bagaimana imunitas mereka naik gitu ya, akhirnya mereka harus berpikir tentang makanan sehat gitu ya. Akhirnya Deli Smoothies selama outbreak mengalami peningkatan yang cukup signifikan. Dari yang kami dapatkan, apa yang harus kita lakukan di saat outbreak ini, hasil dari beberapa obrolan, diskusi dengan banyak teman-teman, a lot of friends in Malang about what we need to do selama pandemi gitu ya. Jadi yang pertama tetap saat kita memulai sesuatu, think about the market, okay. The second one, network. Mungkin network itu adalah ada tidak ada outbreak, saya rasa network tetap butuh ya. And collaborate with others gitu ya. Kolaborasi dengan orang lain ini menarik, saya rasa sudah digaungkan beberapa tahun yang lalu dan menjadi semakin mengalami percepatan di masa pandemi gitu ya. Lalu yang berikutnya, belajarlah cepat gitu. Jadi kita harus belajar cepat, fast learning, terus bergerak dan terus dievaluasi. Jadi belajar, bergerak, ada yang salah, evaluasi, jalan lagi gitu terus. Dan yang menarik adalah di saat kita di masa outbreak ini, empati dan business with good values itu juga sangat penting. Berempati dan menjadi businessman yang jujur gitu ya, yang benar-benar baik ya, dalam tanda kutip baik, itu sangat penting dalam kondisi sekarang. Last few days mungkin ada yang pernah lihat postingannya Burger King ya, yang mereka mengajak customer-nya untuk juga berbelanja di bahkan pesaing terbesarnya mereka, McDonald's gitu ya. Itu menarik sekali. Saya rasa itu selain sebagai marketing tersendiri, tapi itu juga bagian dari empati dalam kondisi sekarang. Mungkin teman-teman juga bisa lihat ya, Pizza Hut juga sampai jualan pinggir jalan ya. Pizza Hut kalau di Malang banyak sekali, karena mereka juga mengalami hal yang sama. Dan sebenarnya ini yang nomor satu seharusnya. Kita jangan pernah lupa kepada Allah ya, kepada Tuhan. Karena ya gitulah, dalam kondisi outbreak ini saya rasa banyak orang yang semakin religius gitu ya. orang-orang semakin mengingat kepada Tuhan. Nah, seharusnya saat kita memulai bisnis, ini yang kita ingat pertama ya. Jadi bukan marketnya dulu, bukan networknya dulu, bukan fast learningnya dan lainnya, tapi kita ingat dulu gitu ya, kepada yang membeli rezeki. Dan ini yang kami alami. Besides Ailani Food, we run Jagoan Indonesia, ya. Jagoan Indonesia, like I say that Jagoan Indonesia itu adalah a creative consultant for SME, for small medium enterprise. Di awal pandemi itu kita membuat yang namanya pahlawan UMKM program. Jadi ya kebetulan hari ini juga hari pahlawan ya, selamat hari pahlawan. Jadi kita di awal pandemi kita buat namanya pahlawan UMKM gitu ya, program pahlawan UMKM yang memang kita inisiatifkan sendiri, free for SME gitu ya. Dan itu adalah proses pendampingan selama satu bulan untuk teman-teman dari UMKM yang merasa terdampak oleh adanya corona itu untuk bisa belajar pelan-pelan melalui online, untuk punya Instagram account gitu ya, punya business Google business account, punya e-commerce account gitu ya. Kita coba dan berkembang sampai sekarang, dan ini sudah masuk mungkin ke sesi kelima mungkin ya, sudah ada ratusan UMKM yang kami coba bantu, dan itu sangat menarik saat kita berempati lebih besar lagi, membantu lebih banyak orang lagi di masa pandemi. Oke, mungkin tidak banyak yang saya sampaikan. Bisa follow dulu mungkin Instagram saya, Dali Kutis juga. Ada Dapur Antar, Jagoan Indonesia. Di akun YouTube Jagoan Indonesia, we share about bisnis yang singkatannya untuk teman-teman UKM, ya, about packaging, about finance, and a lot of videos there, ya. Saya rasa mungkin itu dari saya. Stay healthy, stay safe, and thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much for the amazing presentation from Mr. Ahmad Nasution. And now before we go with the Q&A for Mr. Ahmad Nasution, since we have the Q&A already for Dr. Juwaida, now I would like to introduce you, both of you. Kami ingin memperkenalkan Anda berdua kepada presentasi produk hasil dari rancangan usaha agribisnis. Panitia mohon disiapkan. So as the introduction, we have already done the practice, or in bahasa Indonesia is praktikum, for almost 3 months, and right now we are asking for students to come up with their innovation and creativity. So here are the presentation of our students. Silakan. Okay, while we were waiting for the students, the number of product are 5, yeah. It is agri-food industry products, and also we have a product that has already established, that is batik. Yuk, Kak, silahkan, Kak. Presentation, please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat siang kepada Bapak Ibu pemateri, kepada Bapak Ibu dosen, serta teman-teman semua. Perkenalkan, nama saya Ersalina Yunanida dari kelas D Rancangan Usaha Agribisnis. Pada kesempatan kali ini, saya akan menyampaikan ide produk saya yang saya beri nama Kuko. Nah, jadi Kuko ini tuh merupakan singkatan dari Cookies Short Cornic, yang konsep produknya itu merupakan susu jagung dipadu dengan edible glass yang terbuat dari cookies. Nah, untuk lebih jelasnya, bentuk produk kuku ini bisa dilihat pada gambar yang ada pada slide. Oke, next. Oke, selanjutnya, di value proposition ini, saya menekankan kepada 4 poin kelebihan dari produk saya. Kelebihan yang pertama adalah mengenyangkan. Jadi produk kuku ini mengenyangkan karena mengandung serat yang tinggi yang berasal dari bahan susu dan juga jagung. Ditambah juga dengan cookies-nya itu sendiri. Sehingga cocok untuk menu sarapan, menu makan siang, dan juga menu diet. Kemudian, kelebihan selanjutnya, produk kuku ini juga bergizi serta kaya manfaat. Produk susu jagung ini mengandung antioksidan yang tinggi, yang mana dapat melawan efek negatif dari radikal bebas yang menyebabkan berbagai penyakit, salah satunya kanker. Nah, produk kuku ini juga bisa meningkatkan kekebalan tubuh karena mengandung vitamin yang tinggi. Apalagi di masa pandemi seperti sekarang ini, masyarakat membutuhkan makanan atau minuman yang bisa meningkatkan sistem imun. Jadi, produk ini bisa menjadi salah satu solusinya. Nah, selanjutnya produk kuku ini mengandung kalsium dan protein yang tinggi. Kelebihan selanjutnya, produk ini tidak mengandung bahan pengawet. Jadi dalam pembuatannya, saya berencana untuk menghindari penggunaan bahan-bahan pengawet sehingga aman dikonsumsi oleh berbagai kalangan, khususnya anak-anak. Nah, yang terakhir, saya memberikan inovasi produk yang kekinian, berupa inovasi wadah atau tempat yang terbuat dari cookies dan bisa dimakan, sehingga bisa menjadi daya tarik tersendiri dari produk kuku ini karena masih sangat jarang digunakan oleh produk sejenis. Oke, selanjutnya. Ya, yang terakhir di sini saya memberikan tagline untuk produk saya, yaitu drink, eat, and be happy. Drink dan eat ini maksudnya dalam satu produk, kita bisa minum sekaligus makan. Dan be happy di sini maksudnya, saya mengharapkan setelah masyarakat mengkonsumsi produk kuku ini, mereka bisa merasa bahagia. Dalam artian, mereka bisa kenyang, puas, sekaligus sehat. Nah, sekian pemaparan ide dari saya. Apabila ada kurang lebihnya, mohon maaf. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So, kuku, drink, eat, and be happy. Next, please. Silakan.
Sorry for the people that make a pitch come tropical have a bad signal. So I am Hikmatul Ebutendika and I'm from class E. I would like to present about my friend's product. Next. So the peach gum, there are two forms of this product, ready to drink and ready to process. We offer five tropical flavors such as lemon, pineapple, tamarind, mango, and jackfruit. This fruit we process into powder form. And there are 10 ingredients. There are lotus seed, red date, ice mushroom, dry longan, kundur sugar, peach gum, goji berries, chia seed, rock sugar, and barley, and all the ingredients we process by drying so the can be durable and last for a long time. Next. If another product only have 9 ingredients with original flavor, but we offer 11 ingredients and 10 main ingredients with one additional flavor ingredients, and we offer 5 tropical flavor. To get consumer utility, we give good performance through timelines and friendly services. If consumer have a special desire, they can do a customization. It can be size and composition. We make a good design that unique and interest in order to increase the curiosity of the consumer. So finally, they can decide by the product. We also accept order from out of town. To avoid physical damage, we use bubble wrap and to maintain the cold condition in delivery services. We use dry ice or blue ice and aluminum foil. About accessibility, we have a website, social media. We provide delivery order and we want to build several booths in malls in Malang. About convenience, in the ready-to-process product, we only need soaking for a minute and a boiling. The brand of this product is Peach Gum Tropical. Peach gum is one of the ingredients of this product. We want to show the benefit of peach gum itself. It contains collagen, so it's really good for health and skin and can make you more glow up. But also we want to show another benefit of 10 ingredients, brand image, the positioning that we want to show to the public, to the society, that Peach Gum Tropical is healthy dessert that support a healthy lifestyle and helps restore ideal body condition with 100% natural ingredients and with good content of collagen that can care the beauty of your skin. And the tagline of our product is Peach Gum Tropical give you healthy and beauty with extraordinary taste. Thank you.
Thank you, Peach Gum Tropical, Hikmatul. One more, please.
So here I am explain more about my product.
Oh, punya kamu juga ya, okay.
Yeah. So yes. My product is called Rami, or Indonesia is Rami. The tagline of this product is fashionable with the nature. Next. The material. So the raw material that is often used is silicone in a casing airport, but hemp is a use for this product. Hemp was chosen because it is made from the Bohemian Nivea L plant, or the Latin name for hemp, which is more environmentally friendly. This plant is also used as a raw material for textile product because it is similar to cotton. When compared to cotton, flax, and hemp, hemp has the highest strength. Hemp also has a good resistance to bacterial, fungal, insect, and weathering attacks, high dimensional stability, and good color fastness to light and easy to wash. In this product, I use jute fabric that come from hemp because it's easy to ship. Next. The last is product design. So an example of product design is an illustrated in the picture. So the raw material I will be replaced with the jute fabric. This product is unique because the first is the use of natural fiber as a raw material that is very rarely offered by other product because most of the raw material use leather and silicone. The second is employing housewife around the production site. Hiring housewife around the production location can increase the income of the community around the production location. The reason for choosing a housewife is to be resilient and durable, and then easy to use by consumer. Most of the airport casing product are difficult for consumer to remove. So many of the consumer complain of airport damage due to use of the casing. This product can be a solution for consumer because installation and uninstallation can be done easily by consumer. And then the use of packaging that is more environmentally friendly. The another uniqueness is the use of environmentally friendly is packaging. The packaging used is woven bamboo or anyaman bamboo, which can be reused by consumer. The last is creating a variety of product that will be sold with a certain time. So I will launch a product variation that are only sold at certain time is the final uniqueness. I will make this product have a limited variety so it can only be purchased for a certain time and will not be relaunched. But however, there are also product variation that are sold continuously. Next. Thank you. That's all my presentation. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. That was Hikmatul. And now we go with the last. Oh no, we still have two products, please. Oh, ada fotonya ya, Kak ya.
Baik, Ibu. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Perkenalkan, nama saya Marwah Ibrahim dari kelas I. Di sini usaha saya sama apa itu bekerja sama dengan teman bernama Siti Sokagaya. Nah, bergeraknya di sini kita di industri batik, industri batik. Nah, nama Soko Gaya ini juga memiliki arti Bu. Apa yang berarti Soko Kawi Gajayana. Nah, artinya ini kata dari bahasa Jawa dan nama jalan yang berarti Soko awalan, Kawi itu berarti kukuh atau kuat, lalu Gajayana nama jalan yang ada di Kota Malang. Jadi kita berdomisilinya ini ada di Jalan Gajayana. Itu dan berdirinya juga pada 22 September tahun 2018. Next. Nah, untuk keunggulan dari produk kita, yang pertama, bahan bakunya itu ramah lingkungan dan juga berkualitas. Yang kedua, keunikan motif yang menciri khaskan dari batik Malangan. Yang ketiga, ada garansi produk. Dan yang terakhir, menerima pemesanan di luar motif. Dan ini saya sekarang juga berada di mini galerinya kami, Bu. Dan juga bisa dilihat dari gambar, dari slide, produk-produk kami ada yang siap pakai juga, namun juga ada yang apa namanya masih dalam berbentuk kain. Untuk foto yang berada di atas sendiri itu foto yang termasuk produk kami yang baru rilis, yang pertama yang namanya itu motif pacak banji. Nah, itu pun juga memiliki arti sendiri. Di mana pacak itu nama lain dari monumen atau tugu, sedangkan banji ini kami mengambil dari motif tertua, jadi kami kombinasikan. Untuk yang di bawah itu, untuk yang foto laki-laki itu namanya adalah yukata, yang biasa digunakan di apa namanya baju-baju orang Jepang seperti itu. Jadi kami menambahkan motif beberapa batik di mana yang daerah sininya, daerah dekat lehernya itu ke bawah kita buat motif kawum seperti itu. Dan juga ada yang motif-motif merak itu seperti di gambar. Jadi produknya kita juga melayani yang siap dipakai juga. Next. Next. Nah, alhamdulillahnya juga dari tahun ke tahun kita juga memiliki beberapa kerjasama. Dan alhamdulillah juga beberapa tahun terakhir kami juga sudah pernah bekerjasama dengan Fakultas Kedokteran Universitas Brawijaya juga, di mana batik-batiknya itu bermotifkan anatomi. Nah, seperti yang ada di gambar, ada yang bermotifkan otak, bermotifkan lambung, dan juga bermotifkan ginjal, bahkan ada yang bermotifkan juga mengambil unsur dari ovarium, seperti itu. Nah, itu salah satu juga di gambar foto kunjungan dari salah satu dosen dari Fakultas Kedokteran UB. Seperti itu. Dan motif juga yang paling sebelah kiri ya, kalau dari saya sini, ada motif burung manyar. Nah, motif burung manyar ini juga merupakan motif yang khas dari Kota Malang juga. Dan bisa juga dilihat dari belakang saya, ini salah satu produk-produk yang memang ini apa itu hasil dari kerjasama dengan Fakultas Kedokteran juga. Dan alhamdulillah juga salah satu produk dari kami juga pernah dibawa sebagai souvenir untuk apa namanya dikirim ke Jepang, alhamdulillahnya gitu sudah sampai seperti itu. Dan juga ini yang saya pakai juga ini produk dari kami juga berupa jaket yang bermotifkan kendedes. Ada juga kita sedang mengembangkan juga produk seperti sepatu batik tulis itu rencananya ke depannya juga. Jadi kami juga istilahnya membuat produk yang nantinya bisa juga digunakan sehari-hari, karena kan karena saya merasa kebanyakan orang masih bermindset apa batik itu hanya untuk digunakan acara-acara formal saja seperti itu. Dan juga saya ingin istilahnya kaum muda ini lebih apa ya bangga lagi dengan menggunakan batik gitu, untuk entah itu untuk hanya sekedar nongkrong atau untuk bepergian hangout bersama teman-teman, itu tidak masalah menurut saya untuk memakai batik. Seperti itu. Sekian, terima kasih dari saya. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Marwa, for the nice presentation of your product. Good luck. And now we have the last product, please.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat siang Bapak Ibu guru, Bapak Ibu dosen, pemateri, dan teman-teman sekalian. Saya Frilia Fikriana dari kelas C. Pada kesempatan kali ini, saya akan mempresentasikan tugas RUA saya, yaitu King Banzer. King Banzer sendiri memiliki arti yaitu sanitizer pisang raja. Nah, adanya King Basir ini bertujuan untuk masyarakat untuk memakai produk ini di masa new normal COVID-19. Nah, King Basir sendiri memiliki tagline yaitu semprot, usap, dan bersih. Next. Nah, apa itu King Basir? King Basir adalah produk hand sanitizer dari ekstrak kulit pisang raja. Nah, produk ini bukan hanya hand sanitizer biasa, melainkan hand sanitizer sekaligus berfungsi sebagai pelembab karena terdapat kandungan ekstrak kulit pisang. Nah, dari nilai proposisi dari King Basir sendiri, antara lain yaitu yang pertama dapat membunuh 90% kuman, bakteri, dan virus, kemudian menjadi perlindungan yang tahan lama, kemudian aman untuk kulit dan tidak lengket, kemudian aman terkena makanan, kemudian memiliki beragam tipe, baik itu spray maupun gel, kemudian memiliki beberapa ukuran, baik itu 100 ml maupun 250 ml. Nah, kemudian harga dari ukuran 100 ml ini adalah Rp13.000, dan harga ukuran 250 ml ini adalah Rp25.000. Nah, gambar di samping merupakan King Basir, kemasan dari King Basir, yaitu menggunakan botol spray atau gel. Nah, dengan pot serut. Alasan menggunakan pot serut ini karena dirasa akan menjadi nilai jual atau daya tarik bagi konsumen. Dan pot serut tersebut dapat memanfaatkan konsumen untuk menyiapkan barang agar tidak bercecer di tas. Baik, terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So thank you very much for all of the presentation or product presentation. Kalau tadi Q&A sama Miss Juwaida, now the product comment atau komentar produk will be given with Mr. Ahmad Nasution. So, hello, are you there, Mas Ahmad?
Halo.
Okay. Ibu. Kita punya lima generasi muda nih ya, yang
wah keren-keren banget produknya.
Okay, so kita,
berapa tahun terakhir saya selalu ngikutin produk-produknya teman-teman ya, dan halo.
Halo, Pak. Aman.
Halo.
Yes, we can hear you.
Halo. Halo.
So, I guess we have lost contact also with Mr. Ahmad Nasution, still waiting for him. So, while we were waiting for Pak Ahmad Nasution, Miss Juwaida has left because she has a class right now in Malaysia, so she gave us a message and motivation for young generation. Do not stop inspiring, do not stop making an innovation and creativity so that you will be a good entrepreneur just like Mr. Ahmad Syaban Nasution. So that was the message from Miss Juwaida. I'm going to proceed with Bahasa Indonesia for the next, karena ada Pak Ahmad Syaban Nasution ya. Selain Pak Ahmad Syaban Nasution, kita juga punya Bapak Febriananda Faisal di sini. Di mana Pak? Tunjukkan dirimu, yes. Dan saya juga ingin kepada teman-teman yang tadi sudah mempresentasikan produknya untuk open our, silakan ada di kamera ya. And bersama dengan Pak Ahmad Syaban Nasution, nanti Bapak Febriananda Faisal akan memberikan komentar dikarenakan Ibu Juwaida left terlebih dahulu karena ada kelas. Baik, silakan Pak Faisal untuk online dulu, Faisal. Ya, ini tadi ada produk pangan, produk tas, ya. Kemudian ada produk permen, ya. Tadi gum, ya, Kak. Ya, permen, ya. Ya, ya. Oke. Silakan Pak Faisal ini.
Pak Ahmad sudah online sepertinya.
Pak Ahmad masih kesulitan walaupun online, silahkan. Mr. Faisal Febriananda will be from teori, ya, dari teori RUA kita memberikan masukan. Silakan, Bapak. Pak Faisal? Yes, okay. Nanti tak komen sendiri loh ini, nanti kan saya hari ini moderator yang nggak bisa, because in the classroom I might be your lecturers, but right now I am your moderator, ya. Yeah? I'm not your Raisa because I'm not this, ya. Yeah, okay. Ya, silakan mana Pak Faisal atau Pak Ahmad Nasution? Not yet coming. Yes. Okay, would you please silakan slide-nya dikeluarkan lagi untuk panitia, silakan. Well, please contact Mr. Faisal. I would like to take a look at the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so Coco, yeah, this is cookies, sat corn milk, ya, susu jagung dipandu dengan edible glass yang terbuat dari cookies, ya. So susu jagungnya ada di tengah-tengah, kemudian pinggirnya itu adalah cookies, ya, Kak. So this is very looks very delicious for me, but I have not yet taste the Coco, ya, masih belum tahu. And okay, ini adalah produk pertama, ya, cookies shot corn milk, ya, mungkin susunya dimasukkan di situ, ya, ditembak, ya. Terus habis gitu the next product. We have peach gum tropical. It is next slide please. It is jangan, Kak, kebanyakan. Oke, lagi-lagi sebelumnya. This is ready to drink apa ini? Peach gum tropical, ya, Hikmatul, ya. Is it kind of food or drink or gum?
Dia masuk ke food, Bu.
Food, yes. Oke, ada lemon, pineapple, tamarind, mango, and jackfruit, ya. So I think as the moderator today and also your lectures, this is quite good. And kalau yang tadi yang pertama juga for the penampilan, it is very attractive. And also, but I still don't see it in the peach gum tropical here from lemon, pineapple, tamarind, mango. But mudah-mudahan ini kalau misalnya sudah bisa dibuat, the taste is nice. Oke. Okay. Oh, tadi yang pertama ada message, yaitu drink, eat, and be happy. How about peach gum tropical? Coba lihat slide selanjutnya. Oke. Okay. Peach gum tropical gives you healthy and beauty with extraordinary taste. Yes. Oke. Okay. So this is the vision and mission, yeah, for the uniqueness. Oke. Okay. I think this is very good also. The product is very, ya, karena saya belum lihat fotonya, ya, Kak, ya. Mudah-mudahan ini bisa dibuat. And my suggestion is you also need to pay attention to the consumers, karena kamu ada berapa banyak jenis rasa. So, which one that is consumer needs more? Jadi mungkin kamu bisa produce yang itu. That is for you. Now, let's go with the batik one. Okay, Remy. Oh, okay. Ini adalah fashionable with fabric. Okay, this is good, ya. Yeah? Because right now we used to go traveling by using something in our pocket. For example, cell phone, ya. Yeah. For example, wallet, ya. Yeah. So I think this is kind of good and innovative product. Okay, and also this is environmentally friendly. Okay. So before thank you, how many how many color are you going to have for that one? Mana? Hikmatul, mau bikin berapa warna ini? How many colors do you have for this product? Halo? Kak? Don't sleep, please. Oh, no, yeah. It's just joking. Okay, so I think Hikmatul product good, yeah, because it is handy, bisa dibawa kemana-mana, dan bisa digunakan untuk menyimpan apapun. Okay. Next please, bagus ya, silakan dilanjutkan. So Marwa Ibrahim as the co-founder. Okay, so this is Soko Kawi Gajayana ya, kata bahasa Jawa and nama jalan. Okay, is there any lecturer from RUA that is going to come? So I think Mr. Febriananda also still offline. Now we have the batik ya, ini bagus sekali karena sudah berjalan ya, and sometimes we in our kabupaten ya or daerah ya, sometimes very difficult in finding out the characteristic ya. Jadi kalau misalnya produk Anda di batik ini ya, ingin membawa semua ciri khas Kota Malang ya, and also you have already know what is the fashion about, you make something that is useful, biasanya marketnya adalah para hijabers ya kak, jadi kamu membuat istilahnya tunik, long tunik ya, and also ada dalam bentuk kerah itu ya, seperti kerah tegak, seperti itu yang sangat bagus dan cantik untuk dipakai. That's why I think no wonder kalau tadi Ibu Juwaida gives us the proof or testimony. So I think you have already got the testimony from your customer that is the lecturers of a medical faculty. Yeah. Okay, good luck for Marwa. Yeah. The next one is, for the last one is King Banzer. Yes. Okay. Dengan tagline-nya semprot, usap, dan bersih, ini kayaknya sudah sampai ke tangan konsumen, asalkan jangan semprot, usap, dan bersih untuk kaca atau lantai ya, because this is only the product for hands ya, saya cuma bercanda aja itu tadi. So I think the product is match with the consumers, especially for the pandemic for today that we cannot really do much interaction outside and we need to keep our hand clean. So that was all for me. Now let's go with Mr. Ahmad Nasution.
Halo, Ibu, mohon maaf. Bapak terputus, suara saya terdengar?
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, Pak, please give us your suggestion or comment based on the product.
Okay, mungkin bisa dimulai dari produk yang pertama. Bisa digeser lagi, mohon maaf.
Yeah.
Tadi yang pertama menarik sekali. Pertama dari nama ya, bacanya gimana? Kuko ya, gitu ya. Bacanya Kuko, cookie short corn milk. Oke. Ini yang menarik menurut saya dari tampilan ya, dan keunikannya sangat keren, bagus banget menurut saya. Tinggal sekarang, kalau saya lihat, coba digeser lagi, tadi saya lihat sempat ada value proposition-nya ya. Oke, okay. Menyenangkan, bergizi, dan kaya manfaat tanpa bahan pengawet, inovasi produk kekinian. Nah, menurut saya ini semua masih ngomong tentang bicara tentang produknya itu sendiri ya. Oke, okay. Maksud saya sekarang itu semua orang bisa buat seperti ini ya. Semua orang bisa melakukannya. Memang idenya cukup menarik. Ide awalnya adalah membuat bentuknya yang cukup berbeda, tapi saya punya saran untuk kembali lagi seperti yang kita bahas tadi, bahwa market itu butuh apa gitu ya. Bisa aja dari yang dari kuko ini dibuat itu diarahkan memang ke behavior orang dalam kondisi pandemi sekarang ini. Mungkin banyak yang bekerja di rumah gitu ya, bisa diarahkan menjadi value proposition-nya menjadi membuat apa ya, bekerja menyenangkan, camilan sehat gitu, mungkin juga digabung dari satu kegiatan gitu ya. Jadi dari pengalaman kami selama pandemi, bahkan sebelum pandemi sebenarnya ya,
halo.
Oh, sorry, kenapa putus lagi? Mohon maaf, mohon maaf, mohon maaf. Saya lanjutkan, Ibu, masih kedengaran suara saya?
Oke.
Baik, oke. Jadi kita arahkan produk-produk yang kita buat itu dengan kehidupan orang sehari-hari. Jadi humanismenya seperti apa gitu loh. Sisi humanisme dari produk ini itu seperti apa gitu loh. Produk Kuku ini kalau dalam keseharian itu dia posisinya di mana? Gitu ya, kayak nasi kalau orang Indonesia itu, nasi itu posisinya ya dimakan pagi, makan siang, makan malam gitu loh. Tapi itu perlu diperjelas, positioning itu perlu diperjelas. Jadi seperti yang disampaikan tadi, trennya apa, medicine-nya apa gitu. Cara produk keren banget, penampilan oke banget, tapi orang kapan ya bisa makan ini? Mau sama kopi misalnya, atau mungkin sambil ngeteh, atau bisa jadi mungkin digabung dengan kegiatan tertentu gitu yang menarik. Mungkin itu untuk yang Kuku. Next, produk mungkin coba saya pengen jawab. Setelah Kuku tadi ada, apa tadi ya? Oke, Fix Jam Tropical. Ini bentuk minumannya seperti apa ya? Apa maksudnya dalam bentuk seperti dikemas gitu, atau dalam bentuk seperti apa ya, catan gitu misalnya gitu? Yang buat siapa mungkin bisa jelasin dikit gitu. Kan dia ready to drink, ini dibentuk dalam bentuk botolan gitu misalnya, atau dalam bentuk seperti bubble, apa, minuman-minuman bubble gitu. Karena ini nanti bisa mempengaruhi juga bagaimana teman-teman bisa mendeliver produknya ke konsumennya gitu ya. Jadi kalau dalam bentuk botol, otomatis penjualannya bisa jadi.
Bisa jadi, kita bermain kata ya, lebih jelas ya, atau lebih baik ya. Oke. Yes. Yes, because we have already running out of time.
Saya udah kayak, udah putus. Putus nyambung dapat lagi nih Bu, maaf ya.
We need to for you to little bit lebih cepat ya Bapak ya, because
Okay. Mungkin kalau yang saran saya untuk yang minuman tadi, yang bubble peach jam tadi itu, tentukan dulu, saya nggak tahu tadi bentuknya dalam bentuk botolan atau dalam bentuk seperti catan gitu misalnya, karena itu dalam mengkomunikasinya kepada konsumen akan berbeda. Kalau dalam bentuk catan itu bisa jadi brandingnya harus sangat kuat. Branding harus sangat kuat. Karena namanya produk minuman itu cepat berubah, cepat ada penggantinya gitu ya. Trennya sering sangat sering berubah gitu. Jadi saya rasa branding harus sangat kuat. Nama brandnya, apa yang warnanya, desain kemasannya, terus tagline-nya, termasuk ya benar marketnya seperti apa.
Yes. Okay, yes. Just like watching movie and then there is an advertisement one and one. Okay, so I think that was all we would like to say. We do apologize for the connection of our speaker for today. Thank you very much for having us with you in this webinar today. So before we finish the webinar, I would like to give a concluding remarks. The first one, dalam pemasaran suatu proposisi nilai pelanggan itu terdiri dari jumlah total manfaat yang dijanjikan oleh vendor yang akan diterima oleh pelanggan. So there will be a very important message that is needed for
produsen untuk disampaikan kepada konsumen sebagai imbalan atas pembayaran yang sudah diberikan oleh pelanggan. So customer value proposition is a message that is inside the product, and it can change over time based on the condition of the customer. Ailani Food is one industry that has already conducted so many innovation and creativity. It has been through trial and error within his business, and then after paying a good care to the customer, it helps the industry to be better, especially in the pandemic. So before we end this webinar today, there is a very important message from both of the seminar, from both of the webinar speakers today. The first one is, we need to focus on the customers. We have so many tips. For example, number one, evaluate your customer experience, or mengevaluasi pengalaman konsumen adalah hal yang paling penting. Yang kedua, fokuslah pada konsumen lebih daripada harga. Ketiga, collect customer data. Karena data adalah yang paling penting, apakah produk Anda disukai oleh konsumen atau tidak. Number four is target your most loyal customers. It means sebagai seorang produser, Anda harus paham siapakah konsumen Anda yang paling loyal. And then the last one is segment your customer base, ya, atau segmentasikan produk yang sudah Anda buat. Mudah-mudahan webinar kali ini bermanfaat. I'm Novi Haryati from Department of Agricultural Economics as your lecturer and moderator today. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm going to turn over to Ervan Divaldi as our MC today.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Miss Novi, as a moderator. And also thank you everyone. We appreciate you being here. Namun sebelum acara kami akhiri, ada absen terlebih dahulu untuk diisi terkait dengan absen mahasiswa dan juga link sertifikat bagi peserta yang berasal dari umum. Untuk panitia mungkin bisa ditampilkan terlebih dahulu untuk link absennya. Baik, berikut yang atas merupakan absensi bagi mahasiswa agribisnis 2018 dan juga yang bawah merupakan terkait dengan link referensi umum terkait pemberian sertifikat untuk peserta.